5 सेकेंड, 2 सेकेंड, रेडी। मिस्टर वाइस चेयरमैन सर, आफ्टर हियरिंग द रोरिंग वाटरफॉल स्पीचेस, गिविंग आउट ऑल द डिटेल्स ऑफ द शॉर्ट कमिंग्स एंड पिटफॉल्स ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट एंड इट्स पॉलिसी एंड द ग्रिम पिक्चर ऑफ द वर्किंग ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट, आई हु इज नॉट एन इकोनॉमिस्ट इन माई ओन हम्बल कैपेसिटी वुड लाइक टू होल्ड अ स्मॉल लैम्प ऑफ होप एंड फेथ इन द गवर्नमेंट्स इकोनॉमिक पॉलिसीज एंड इट्स प्लानिंग। Mistakes are always made, otherwise we are not humans. Differences of emphasis and working are always there, but it does not mean that we should summarily opinion that everything is wrong. Sir, in framing these budget proposals, the finance minister had a very difficult and very delicate task to perform. The first step that he had to take was to accelerate the economic growth both on the agricultural and the industrial front, and secondly, to maintain some price stability. The very fact that the prices of certain essential commodities did not shoot up after the budget was itself an act of great relief to many consumers, especially to housewives who always used to sit up tight, keeping the fingers crossed, not knowing what items are going to be on which the axe of the finance minister will fall. For the first time, this continuous fear has been belied to a great extent after the presentation of the budget. And so, sir, placed as we are in an extremely difficult economic situation, many common consumers and housewives like me think that the finance minister deserves all congratulations for presenting this year a growth-oriented budget. Sir, the national budget is not only an annual accounting of expenses and revenues, but the finance minister has to give through the budget a correct picture of the present as well as of the hopes for the future. Sir, it is the prerogative of not only the small microscopic affluent class to sit in judgment, but also the common people who have an equal right to say something about the budget. Sir, irrespective of any other pressures, especially where it is well known that this is the pre-election year, the budget reflects the underlying main stress on the economic considerations. This itself shows the determination to overcome the critical period by introducing a number of measures for different sections of the people. It stresses the proper investment priorities and curtailment of non-essential consumption items. In a situation where almost everything is being highly taxed, leaving no scope for further taxation to raise the revenue resources. The finance minister invented a new concept in the form of excise taxation on all luxury goods produced in our country for sale or other commercial purposes, and thus made it logically a sound proposal. The battle against the prices, which was started about a year back, has become more favorable because of the number of bold measures taken by the government to bring down and slacken the price rise. The finance minister has correctly emphasized the need to boost the climate for savings and investment by offering a number of incentives like exemption from wealth tax for a period of 5 years for the new companies engaged in priority industries, and also by offering a special incentive for investing corporate savings in new companies producing fertilizer, paper, cement, etc. Sir, much is said about no relief being given to corporate sector, but it is not true, as the government is really concerned over their financial problems and would like to give whatever cooperation possible to them in the present circumstances. For example, the dividend restrictions have been loosened and the Act will also be suitably amended. Sir, similarly, there are a number of welcome gestures for middle class people like higher house rent allowance, travel concessions, higher permissible deduction for contribution to provident fund and life insurance premia, etc. A proviso for deduction of expenses for higher education of children per individual having an annual income up to ₹24,000 is also noteworthy. Sir, all these savings-oriented income tax relief provisions no doubt deserve merit. Sir, I would like to make some observations. First is that the bonus for non-withdrawal of provident fund by government employees should be extended not only to the public sector but also to the private sector employees covered by the provident fund scheme. It is very necessary today to see that the large number of people withdraw less, spend less, and save more. Sir, another point is regarding the number of complaints we hear about the cumbersome procedure involved in the issue of licenses, permits, etc. If this procedure could be rationalized, it will stop to a considerable extent the underhand dealings that are prevalent at present. Sir, another problem is the rise in market borrowings at an alarming rate. Although the working of the public sector has considerably improved in the last few years, मच मोर इज एट टू बी डन टू रीच द टारगेट ऑफ एफिशिएंसी. द पब्लिक सेक्टर अंडरटेकिंग्स हैव टू बी गियर्ड टू बिकम प्रॉफिट ओरिएंटेड.